Well, Indiana and Kentucky state fire marshals are putting out a warning now about the 4th of July fireworks to prevent possible disaster. Fire officials tell WLKY these weather conditions that we are currently having are historic, therefore drastic bans and warnings are being put into place. WLKY's Ann Bowden joins us now live from the one local spot that concerns Indiana officials the most. Ann?
Well, Rick, I'm here at Ashland Park in Clarksville, Indiana, near the K&I Bridge, and fire marshals tell me this is, unfortunately, a very popular spot for people to come and shoot off some fireworks for fun. It may be fun for them, but the problem is what goes up must come down. So when the fireworks come up and the embers come down, if they ignite any of this foliage or that driftwood that you see, fire marshals say that could spell disaster.
These conditions are historic. The conditions that we're under right now with the extreme heat and dry conditions present unprecedented, really, dangers and hazards for fire.
These are the scenes firefighters on both sides of the river say are highly possible. Wildfires started by a spark like this one spanning Bullitt, Hardin, and Southern Jefferson counties in 2010, and this one in Hopkinsville just last month. Fire marshals say in this dry, parched atmosphere, ignition can come from a heated piece of glass, a gas or charcoal grill, a cigarette.
A tossed cigarette 80% of the time will create a fire at this point in time.
And especially fireworks. The trouble has already started with those.
And we had three within 15 minutes Thursday night. This morning we actually made one of the round bales on fire was due to fireworks that had been discharged.
And according to the Kentucky Department of Forestry, the state has had several fires every day since June. That's why 76 out of 120 counties are under a burn ban. According to the Indiana Department of Homeland Security, 84 of its 92 counties are under a burn ban. And some counties are prohibiting fireworks.
And it's not taking a lot for things to really get interesting. Just a little ember that you could get by with normally is turning into a large mess right now.
And federal law can prohibit fireworks. While some states have a law saying a city ordinance can't prevent fireworks during the holiday, a federal emergency disaster declaration can override that law. That's what some counties are doing. For those that aren't, they're asking for your responsibility.
The dry conditions here are of historic proportions, so let's make sure we think about our responders, our firefighters out there having to respond to these when you're using and doing your type of activities around the home.
And Rick and Vicki, you also have to be responsible for your neighbors. If you set off fireworks on your property and it gets into your neighbors starting fire or damage, that could be a civil or criminal fine of up to $2,500. Also, have a water supply ready, a rake and shovel, just in case you have an accident. Reporting live here at Ashland Park, Ann Bowden, WLKY News.